Nationally, crashes that occur at or near intersections are responsible for 1/4 of all traffic-related fatalities and about half of all injuries. Many states, such as South Carolina, have made reducing crashes at intersections a high priority.
This project began in 2009. At the time, our Strategic Highway Safety Plan had a goal to reduce fatalities and serious injuries by 25%. This systemic approach and this project was one of the ways we wanted to achieve that goal.
The agency conducted a 5-year analysis of traffic crash data and identified intersections as a place where low-cost safety improvements could be made.
Traditionally, you would take the number of crashes over a 3-year period and design very customized improvements to fix an intersection. The problem with that is it's reactive, time-consuming, and very expensive.
Instead of the traditional approach, it involves 3 steps. First, analyze system-wide data to identify a problem. Next, look for similar risk factors present in many severe crash locations, then look for other locations with similar risk factors. Finally, deploy low-cost countermeasures. The key, however, is to do this on a large scale across a community or region.
I think in the past, our typical approach was to install hotspot locations, which may involve a signal or left turn lane. The cost of such projects would be roughly $500,000. This systemic approach allowed us to treat nearly 80 projects for the same price of one.
The South Carolina DOT identified and targeted more than 2,000 locations across the state to receive improvements, mostly in the form of updated signing and pavement markings. The intent was to reduce the frequency and severity of crashes at stop-controlled intersections by alerting drivers to the presence and types of an approaching intersection. They started with a standardized package of enhanced signing and pavement markings and tailored each site as necessary. The standardized package included signs on both the left and right side of the road, larger oversized signs with high-intensity fluorescent sheeting, retroreflective signpost panels, solar-powered signpost-mounted flashing beacons. Pavement marking improvements included properly placed stop bars, double solid yellow center lines and dashed lane edge lines, lane use arrows, and word messages. Additional systemic treatments can include removing obstructions that limit sight distance, advanced transverse rumble strips, or high friction surface treatment.
Friction at intersections is important because of the constant patterns of slowing, turning, yielding, and stopping. Higher friction can reduce the critical distance needed to stop. So higher friction at an intersection can be the difference between a close call and a crash.
A scientific analysis of more than 400 improved stop-controlled intersections in South Carolina over a 10-year period showed a 10% decrease in fatal and injury crashes. Each intersection improvement cost an average of $6,000, resulting in a benefit-cost ratio of 8-1.
I've been in the traffic safety field for over 20 years, and this project has had the greatest safety impact of any that I've been involved with.